Hi, this is Ryan Brown from mockquestions.com. In today's video, we will be discussing 5 project manager interview questions. But before we do that, just a quick disclaimer. These questions are not guaranteed to be asked at your interview. I've pulled all of today's questions and answers from our website, mockquestions.com. Now, let's get started. Question number 1. What is the most important skill that a project manager needs to be successful? Given that project managers use and rely on many different skills, there are several ways you can answer this question. Let the interviewer know what skill you believe is most important to your job, whether it be related to organization, communication, negotiation, leadership, or time management. And back up your opinion with a related example, if possible. There are many different skills that I use to do my job well. For example, I need to be able to communicate clearly to different groups and types of people. It's also imperative that I be a strong leader who can motivate and inspire others. I also need to be capable of overseeing budgets, negotiating with vendors, and managing my time and resources. But I personally think that the most important skill I possess in terms of this position is my ability to be organized. I recently worked on a large project with lots of moving parts. I remained organized throughout the entire process, managing the timeline, client and sponsor expectations, the budget and team responsibilities, and in the end, completed it successfully. Question number 2. What is the most successful project you've managed to date? Remember that the interviewer is considering hiring you to oversee complex projects for their company. And as they say, the proof is in the pudding. The interviewer wants assurance that you are capable of managing projects, so give an example or 2 of past projects you've led that ended successfully. Clearly explain the details of the project, your role and actions, and the final result. I previously worked for a bank that needed to establish consistent and reliable data to be used for decision-making purposes. As a leader of this project, I determined that we needed to decommission multiple legacy systems, hundreds of spreadsheets, and several other tools and platforms in order to standardize the data. Once the scope of the project had been laid out and I had run a RAID analysis, I put all the details of the project into an online project management program, assembled teams, set expectations, and established timelines. I communicated clearly to the various parties that participate in the project, from upper management to the IT team and other employees. Ultimately, the project was completed within budget and on time, and it allowed the bank to standardize its data, improve its transparency, and reduce costs. Question number 3. What do you do to prevent scope creep? Scope creep can be a real problem for project managers. It occurs when the project's objectives shift as it progresses, which can lead to the project going over its budget and/or timeline. The interviewer wants to be assured that you know how to recognize and handle scope creep. Talk to them about how you would prevent it from occurring and what you would do if it did happen. Scope creep can be a real problem that results in unhappy customers or stakeholders and a blown budget and/or timeline. In my experience, it tends to occur when there is a lot of client and or stakeholder feedback that the project manager doesn't correctly manage. Feedback is good, but many times it comes along with additional requests. I've learned that the best way to handle these kinds of requests is to clearly explain to the customer or stakeholder how fulfilling a specific request will change the cost and timeline of the project. Then I only add this to the project scope if the client stakeholder accepts these costs and timeline changes. I also make sure that the scope of the project is spelled out at the beginning of the project and that I keep track of the smaller tasks and goals as they are achieved so we don't veer off course. In the instances when scope creep does occur, I move quickly to establish and communicate new expectations. Question number 4. How do you facilitate the success of your teams? As a person in charge of the project and all the teams who are making it happen, you need to be someone who can motivate and manage others. The interviewer wants to know how you do this. Mention the stages that all teams move through: forming, storming, norming, performing, and adjourning. Discuss how you've supported and led teams before. I am a natural leader who loves to inspire and support others. I always start a project by assembling strong teams that are filled with hard workers who are passionate and smart. From there, I can easily recognize the various stages a team moves through as I've witnessed it many times now. First, they experience forming when they start to learn about each other. Then there tends to be storming when conflict arises between team members as they realize they have differing opinions about things. My role at this point is to encourage them to hear each other out and be respectful. Then comes the norming stage, as they begin to accept each other and truly work as a team. My favorite is the performing stage, which is when my team begins to function like a well-oiled piece of machinery, many parts all working toward one goal. It's always kind of sad when we get to the end of the project, the adjourning stage, and they move on to other projects and responsibilities. But throughout the entirety of the project, I listen, remind, offer encouragement, guide, and help resolve conflicts so we all together reach our final project goal. Question number 5, how do you manage customers and stakeholders? Project managers interact with and oversee different groups during projects, ranging from vendors and teams to customers, executives, and stakeholders. The interviewer wants to know how you change your communication style and approach depending on who your audience is, particularly when the person or group you're addressing has authority over the project. Discuss how you convey the project's objectives, cost, and timelines to customers and stakeholders. Communication is one of the most important parts of my job. I have to convey expectations, establish boundaries, maintain control, soothe disgruntled workers and/or stakeholders, and so much more. When it comes to customers and stakeholders, I aim to please them and keep them 100% satisfied. I do this by initiating communication early on and then keeping them updated on the progress of the project. Some stakeholders and clients want frequent communication while others don't. I gauge this and then react appropriately. In general, my conversations with stakeholders and customers are concise and just overviews unless they have requested additional detail. If something changes during the project, I keep them apprised so they are fully aware of any potential changes to the project's budget or timeline. Thank you for watching. If you want to continue practicing for your project manager job interview, click our link below or head over to mockquestions.com today and get started.